sprout in the middle of the desert in Johnson Valley, California. My buddy Cody called me. He's got this 40-acre compound that he built called Lasertown. It's totally insane. It's probably not like anything that I think you've ever seen before. We're gonna go drive on some rocks in his moon buggy. And if you don't know what that is, you just buckle in and come check it out. So, Pretty Penny, aptly named, right? You've got copper-plated wheels, dude. I don't know anybody who takes real copper, plates their wheels, and then goes beats the crap out of them.
Yeah, it's just what we do.
Whose wheels are they, actually?
Those are Raceline's.
Oh, nice.
And they're disruptor beadlocks, double beadlocks. Mm-hmm. It's a 20-inch wheel, 42-inch tire.
So your little spaceship here has a lot going on.
Oh yeah.
I mean, this is not just like get in a car and steer it.
Yeah, there's a lot going on.
Right. So let's first talk about this Atlas transfer case.
Yeah.
Because in order to have four-wheel drive, you have to, what the Atlas does is it allows you to engage the rear or engage the front or engage them both at the same time.
Correct.
In both high or low range.
Yeah. When you're on a rock crawling course and you're competing, you want to be able to disengage the front or rear. So say this is the rear shifter, mm-hmm. and you want to hit it out. Right now, it's disengaged and you only have power going to the front.
Right.
And to get the best score, you need to be able to sometimes turn really tight. So you'll pull your cutting brakes, locking the rear up, with the rear has no power, and the front has power, and it'll burn. They call it a burn, and it'll build a burn around.
Or a front dig
mm-hmm. to get in a better spot and avoid taking a backup.
You have lockers front and rear, air controlled.
Correct.
ARB air lockers, right?
Yes.
And when you put it in four-wheel drive without a locker, the power is really just going to go to the wheel that has the least resistance. So if you expect all four tires to actually be turning at the same time, you've got to lock your axles.
Yes.
And by having an air switch to control that, it's just on the fly.
With the locker, you're able to disengage and able to steer better,
right,
and maneuver through the obstacles, which really helps out. And then when you want the locker on, it locks it up 100% and gives you four-wheel drive.
This is where you control your rear steering. You've got redundancy. You have it, way over there?
Yeah, we have three different spots. We found that sometimes the switch doesn't want to work, but mm-hmm. I originally had the rear steer down here. So I'd find myself, mm-hmm. when you're in here and you need to, you know, say my hand's here,
sure,
or on the steering wheel,
it's a lot.
And I had to come down here to hit the switch. Well, I was hitting it out of gear when I was doing it. And I'm like, well, you know what? It'd be kind of cool if I could hold on to it. Because sometimes you're going off 10-foot drops, you're climbing, you're bouncing. It's cool to be able to hold on to something and adjust it at the same time, which it's worked bitchin' right there.
Now, this is interesting. And people are going to be like, why on earth is there a winch mounted between your legs, run up over the chassis and onto the front axle?
Well, one reason why the winch is where it's at, because if you look at the package, there's really nowhere for a winch. It does real good at winching the front down. So
you can keep yourself from rolling over by bringing the chassis a little bit down, and you can control that.
Yep.
It's really strange that your engine is in the back, but that also gives you great visibility in the front. What are you running back here?
It's a 2.2 Ecotec, a GM motor. Mm-hmm. Puts out about 260 horsepower, has a little turbo on it. Nothing fancy. You know, it has some upgraded pistons to handle the turbo. CBM Motorsports built this motor. It's actually on a 15-degree angle.
Yeah,
so you can actually view out the side, because if it wasn't on the angle, it would be way...
You couldn't turn and see this tire engine.
So this engine, it's a lot lower than other moon buggies because we put a sump system on it to be able to get it lower, and you made a custom pan.
Would you explain portal axles?
Portal, it just brings the axle up so you have more clearance.
It's shaped like this, right? Like it comes up instead of just being straight down. Because normally your differential, your pumpkin, would be hanging way down here.
It hangs down there and it'll hit a rock. I mean, the portals are so much clearance. If you look underneath, it actually, the skid plate hangs a little lower than the bottom of the diff. I don't remember the last time I even worried about, I got my diff even on the passenger side. It's so much clearance, you don't have an issue. And what's cool about the portals also is you're able to run smaller drive shafts, smaller gears.
Right.
and
less to break if you have a shorter distance,
less torque on all that stuff, and it's lighter.
And so you've got air shocks, and you don't have a lot of up travel. What's going on? Is that just so it can drop out primarily?
Yeah, pretty much so it drops out. We actually, the air shocks need to have a little nitrogen put in them. Mm-hmm. Normally want about 4 inches of shaft showing.
Right.
And so they're normally not that low.
I mean, you make all of these pieces, right?
Yeah, we do laser cutting. We do laser cutting and bending and welding and a number of other things. But we're a job shop laser cutting facility, mainly cater to the off-road industry, aftermarket.
Okay.
A lot of my customers are my friends, my partners, my sponsors. Mm-hmm. It's a really tight-knit group of people that all know each other, and we do a lot of laser cutting for a lot of different companies.
So they'll just send you a CAD drawing or a napkin drawing,
and you'll figure it out.
Obviously, looking all over this laser town, you've made a ton of stuff here.
Yeah.
Did you make your cactus?
Yes, we did.
So what does the entire thing weigh?
I'd say it's 2,300 pounds
without
steel shot.
These tires have a whole bunch of like BBs in them.
Yes.
Like how many pounds in each front tire?
300.
300 pounds in each front tire of steel shot. And so everybody at home is like, why would you do that? It's like a dead blow hammer. It's like like you could stick really good.
Yeah, it sticks really good, and the inertia of the shot once it gets going, especially up a climb, actually slings you forward.
So what's happening is when you light up these tires and they're spinning, and that shot spins way out, and then if you were to like stab the brake or something, it all boom and once, and it kind of propels you and sticks you down. It's like having a 300-pound man stand on every corner.
Yeah,
of your car.
It's pretty wild. And being that most of the weight is in the back, it balances the car out so it has the right weight ratio from the front to the rear.
This is let's go peel out, man.
Cool, let's do it.
Nothing on the rear. Rear locker's off. Hold the cutting brakes. Okay. To crawl that wall, but we just went for it. Well, that's one way to get off a Connex box. Dude, did you want me to hang for a while? Because I'm in a hurry, Cody.
What do you think?
It was fine.
Yeah?
I haven't wheeled in a long time, and you just throw me in and drop me off a wall.
Well, that's what I hear that you like to just be thrown into it.
Let's just go drive a flagpole.
Yeah, want to do a flagpole?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do it. So make sure your lockers are engaged.
Yes, lockers are on.
Four-wheel drive. First gear. You have your pillow?
I have my pillow. We're good, I have my pillow.
Okay, Nicole, come on, follow me. You're gonna head right here where my hand is.
You want the rear out? Rear's fine. I see it now. Straighten it.
20-foot climb. All she's going on it all by herself.
So Cody has been spotting me pretty much all day. He's standing at the top of that big old notch that we're gonna go drive. Obviously, eyes outside of the vehicle, which is really helpful because kind of limited as to, even though this has great visibility, it's always great to have a spotter, and that's how we do it in competition. So I'm gonna take him up on it. Am I gonna clear this little rock? You got such great clearance in this thing. Shannon Campbell buggy, obviously pro mod, 37s, two seat. It's probably, you know, the most capable thing that I've driven besides this. Doesn't need to push. So, yeah, no, I'm good. On the left. Pin it.
actually drive it. I can't believe how capable this buggy is. I had a rock buggy that was, you know, we did the same courses as these Unlimiteds, but the capability difference is insane. This is really cool. Cody, where are you? You're still up there. Dude, thank you. This is awesome. You can't hear it, but he's saying, good job. You went right up, it didn't spin a tire, and it was bitching. That's what he just said. This is so sick, man. Dude, that was a fun day. I appreciate it. And we're sitting on a dock in the middle of the desert with our feet in a koi pond.
Yeah, Lasertown has a little bit of everything. It's America, the way I look at it. In California, of all places.
Right.
Thank you for coming. And I appreciate you coming out and having a good time with us.
It was cool. You got some mad skills as a driver. I've been watching you for years. And I appreciate you letting me come out. And you know what, you guys? Like, comment, subscribe. Please keep all of that engagement coming, and we will see you next time.
I don't.
You don't have a signature move? You got this. I have so much sweat. We're never using that, ever.
Oh, they're over here.
Jeez.
I don't. My memory, I don't remember what I did yesterday. Okay. What's interesting about it being boring is it is boring ish. Okay.
You can't say that.
Oh, why not? It was PG-13, I thought.
Right. Okay. It is boring as crap.
It's boring as crap.